What's up, Guardians? Avian Flew here with a really fun ad-clearing build for the Hunter class that I'm calling Bombs Away. This build concentrates on clearing a room within seconds using mini-bombs, blights, our fists, and a hail of gunfire. It synergizes the ability-refreshing nature of Top Tree Arcstrider with the bomb-dropping capabilities of the Bombardier exotic boots to give us an endless payload of bombs and arc fists. With the right combination of mods, we can increase our weapon and charged melee damage, making this a good burst DPS build as well. To set up this build, you'll want to use Top Tree Arcstrider. This subclass gives the ability Combination Blow, which increases our melee damage, stacking up to 3 times, and triggers health regeneration. It also lets us use the ability Combat Flow, which recharges our dodge ability on melee kill. This synergizes with the Bombardier boots, since our dodge ability is what drops the bomb. The super ability Arc Staff is also great at deleting a lot of enemies quickly. The weapon loadout can be flexible. This is the best combination that I found during my tests. You want to have as many of them masterworked for the orb generation. In the primary slot, I decided to use the very popular exotic grenade launcher, Witherhoard. This weapon's projectiles blight the target or area, causing damage over time, making it extremely effective for crowd control. In the energy slot, I'm running the Future War Cult SMG, Stochastic Variable. This SMG, or any other arc weapon, synergizes with the Well of Eons mod, but we'll get into that later. I've been loving this weapon, and it's farmable from the Prismatic Recaster, making it easy to get a god roll. Since we'll mostly be in close range with this build, a sword seemed like the best weapon in the power slot. I'm using the Falling Guillotine, since it's still the best non-exotic sword that isn't the Crown Splitter. Moving on to the armor. For the helmet, I'm using a Grenade Launcher Ammo Finder perk and an SMG Targeting perk. In the fourth slot, I'm using High Energy Fire, which increases our weapon damage when charged with light. Next, let's look at the gloves. I have it tuned to Arc so that I can use the Well of Eons mod in the fourth slot. This mod causes our next melee hit to deal increased damage after picking up an Arc Well. In the other slots, I use Reload mods or Champion mods for higher level activities. Next is the chest piece. I'm using Melee Damage Resist mod since we will be operating at close range. I'm also using a Grenade Launcher Reserve mod for more Witherhoard ammo. In the fourth column, you'll want to use Taking Charge, which gives you charges of light when picking up orbs of power. For the leg armor, this build uses the Bombardier's boots. This is a totally forgotten exotic. Its intrinsic perk is Parting Gift, which drops an explosive after dodging that damages all enemies around it. This explosive does between 10 to 15,000 damage, depending on proximity to the explosion. Since this ability is chainable with this build, it becomes a very effective crowd control tool. For the mods, I'm using Absolution, which reduces all ability cooldowns when picking up orbs of power. I'm also using the seasonal mod version of Grenade Launcher Scavenger, which only costs 1 energy. In the fourth column, I'm using Elemental Armaments, which has an increasing chance of creating an arc well when we get kills with an arc weapon. In this case, our Stochastic Variable, Ikelos SMG, Arc Logic Auto Rifle, etc. Last, we have the cloak. Obviously, we're using Breach and Clear for the increased damage buff when damaging a boss, champion, or breaking a shield with a grenade launcher. If you have 1 energy to spare, Elemental Light is a good mod because it generates arc wells when we get super kills. These arc wells increase our melee damage output, but only for one punch, so the more wells we make, the more damage we can do. With this loadout and perk combination, we have multiple ways to clear the battlefield within seconds, making this build a crowd-killing machine. There's no real order to making this build work. It's more about managing which ability is up and which ability needs to be refreshed. You simply blight an area with Witherhoard, then run into a group of enemies and either dodge to drop a bomb on them, or melee kill a single enemy to start the combination blow chain. Then, just use whatever ability is ready to recharge the ability on cooldown, rinse and repeat. This build took me a while to find the right weapons and mods, but once I landed on this particular combination, it became a lot of fun to use with a lot of utility. That wraps up this Hunter build. I hope it helps you bomb your enemies straight to hell, and most importantly, that it's fun to use. As always, a like and sub is appreciated and lets you stay up to date with my newest content. Thanks for stopping by, and see you next time.